بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله ما بعد والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. That's it? That's all you can come up with? I came all the way halfway around the world from America. That's the way Mr. Bush said, America. I came all the way from, don't make fun of the boy Bush, okay? I came all the way around, halfway around the world from America, and I give you a Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, and what are you giving me back? Come on, man, show me what's Bangalore made out of. Let me hear you. Assalamu alaikum! Okay, take it easy, man. Whoa! That's healthy lungs, man. Alhamdulillah. I got a question for you. How come half the seats are empty over here? What's going on? Did you not know you were supposed to bring people here to learn about Islam? Forgot to tell you what? Let's do an inventory real quick. How many here are not Muslim yet? Raise your hand. You see how I left the positive thinking open? How many are not Muslim yet? Raise your hand. One? Only one? Where? Where's two? How you doing? Okay, how many are Muslim yet? Whoa! By the way, to our non-Muslim guests, how do you like being surrounded by all these terrorists? Oh, sorry. Can't believe he said that, can you? No. Anyhow, this is Yusuf Estes, the National Muslim Chaplain in the United States of America. And we've got a program that we do. It's called Islam Tomorrow. And certainly that's expressing a hope of a better life for all of us. We talk about tomorrow, the future, something good. So I like that name, Islam Tomorrow. But then on the other hand, we do a lot of recordings and we broadcast them later. And so what you're watching is really not tomorrow, it's yesterday. So we have another website called IslamYesterday.com, and that's where we put all the audios and videos. But then for those who are saying like, well, wait a minute, I think Islam is a little bit more inclusive than that. We also have IslamAlways.com. How about that? So we got it all. Huh? Yeah, right. Anyway, we came here tonight to talk on the subject of science. Science. Why would a religion be talking about science? You ever ask that question? Why? For our non-Muslim guests, by the way, you are most welcome. And we're happy and thankful to Allah that He lets you come be with us. You don't realize how much we want more people to come and learn about Islam. Earlier, Dr. Jaffer Sheikh Idris was speaking on one of my favorite subjects. They called it by another title, but whenever I give it, I take all of what they say and I bring it down where people, little people like me, can understand it in simple terms. So that whenever you ask me a question, I try to do it in commercial time. Commercial time is 30 seconds, not 30 minutes, okay? In 30 seconds on TV, they try to sell you a new car, a new house, an investment program. Am I right or wrong? I mean, they get it out there really quick. Some of their commercials that they have are weird. They don't even mention the product. They just show you a lady walking by, not too much clothes. Just, hey, there you go. Buy a car from Joe. What's that? But anyhow, I thought because so many people today, most of the people today know it's TV, right? Everybody has TV. And so I thought, let's keep everything simple. So the subject is truth and proof. This thing went to sleep. Wake up. I don't know what happened, but truth and proof. Subject the Sheikh was talking on is exactly the same thing that I'm carrying forward with, only I'm picking up another side of what he said. You cannot have faith if you don't have any knowledge. And that's what he said. But I put it in simple terms, because what happened to me, let me introduce the story a little bit before I jump to my topic. Can I do that? Is it okay? Let me tell you what happened. My dad came, I used to preach Christianity. Most of you know that. That's one of the reasons they like to bring me. The other one is I'm a white guy from America. But anyhow, when I give the talks, they want me to mention something about this. There's nothing wrong, really, with a person who doesn't know what's wrong, as Sheikh said, when they do know and they don't know anything about it. That's a big sin. So when I was in jahiliyyah, ignorance, and I didn't know any better, and I was trying, Allah gives credit for that person. Provided as something better comes, they accept it. When I met the Muslim that ultimately helped me get to Islam, I was trying to convert him to Christianity. When I met him, I was trying to tell him all about Christianity, and I didn't give him a chance to speak whatsoever. Okay? If you've ever been around the Mormons, you know what I'm talking about. Just boom, 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 boom. They give it to you. Or actually, it's more like Jehovah's Witness. Just ak-ak-ak-ak-ak, and you don't get to say anything. And that's the way I was working. Do you believe in God? He said, yeah. Yeah, but do you believe in Abraham? He said, yeah. Do you believe in Moses? Yeah. Do you believe in the Old Testament of the Bible? He said, yes. Yes, but do you believe in the New Testament? He said, yes. But do you believe in the saving name of Jesus? He said, yeah. What? You do? I don't know what to say. I thought, wait a minute. Because we were told by other preachers, and I'm not going to mention names, because it'd be wrong if I said like Jimmy Swaggart, Benny Hinn, stuff like that. That'd be wrong, so I'm not going to do it. What? Oops. I got jet lag. I've slipped. Anyhow. Anyhow, what they told us, they said, Muslims don't even believe in God. They worship a black box in the desert, and they kiss the ground 5 times a day. That's what they told us. And I bought it. What do I know? When I met this gentleman from Egypt, I was impressed with his character. His demeanor was so nice and sweet. I said, man, you know, if we make him a Christian, we can make him better than Mother Teresa, better than a saint. We'll make him an angel. Because he's so nice, he's so kind, he's so gentle, he's so, you know. For 3 months I worked beside this guy, and the more I watched him, the more I was impressed. I said, what a great Christian he's going to make. By the way, I'm forever the optimist. It happened, and I'm not exaggerating when I tell you, it happened real quick in my mind when he hit me with it, though. He said to me, I'll go to your religion. I went, what? He said, yeah, I'm ready to be a Christian. I'll go to your religion if your religion is better than my religion. I said, get the baptismal baby. We're going to get him ready. We're going to dunk him. And we're going to make him a Christian tonight. Yes. Woo, in the water, out you come. Hello. He said, but, you'll need proof. Okay, my PhD happens to be in theology. And the first thing you learn, I guess philosophy the same way. Religion or any belief system is that. It's based on what you believe. A religion is based on faith. And that was your subject, faith, right? It's not based on any kind of proof. If you want to talk about proof, what are you talking about? You're talking about science. You're not talking about faith anymore. He said, in my religion, we have both. We have faith and we have the science. So we have the proof and the truth. And you put that together, and what can you say? It becomes very clear. It becomes very clear after you look into what Sheikh Jaffer was talking about earlier, that if you know anything at all and you act on it, that is correct. And as you get more knowledge, you act on that. And look at the statement he told me. If your religion's better than my religion, I'll go to it. And I know he was not lying. Because every Muslim should have that in their heart. You show me something better, a better way to get closer to Allah, a better way to guarantee a salvation with Almighty God, then I'm with you. I'll take it. You got it? I'll go for it. Provided what? You got to prove it. I don't want to hear about your dream last night, okay? I don't want to hear about your feeling that you got down in your heart, okay? And you got something in your stomach going around and around. I don't know, maybe you drank the water over here. I don't know. But I'm telling you, that's not what we're buying. What we're looking for is cold, hard evidence.